Good Monday morning, everyone. Welcome to our show. Tesla Giga Shanghai was recently featured in an exclusive walkthrough from China's Xinhua news agency. Over the course of the video, a number of key factors about the massive electric vehicle factory were shared. These included the facility's Tesla speed, which is quite remarkable. By the way, in the description of this video, I will have the link so you can see Xinhua's entire report. Giga Shanghai has become a crucial part of Tesla's global operations today. The facility does not only cater to the domestic Chinese market, it also serves as the company's primary vehicle export hub. With this in mind, it is pertinent for Tesla to ensure that the Giga Shanghai is operating as optimally as possible. While exploring the assembly lines of Giga Shanghai, the Xinhua host inquired how long it currently takes to produce a Model Y from start to the end. An employee from Giga Shanghai remarked that from the first station to the final station, it takes about 2.5 hours to finish a Tesla Model Y. This is a record number. I don't know any other company that does this. Do you guys know? See, look what he said. He said, I think from the first station to the last station, it takes about 2.5 hours to finish all the stations, the Gigafactory Shanghai employee said to Xinhua host. Now, back in 2020, if you remember, Herbert Diess, former CEO of Volkswagen, said it takes Volkswagen 30 hours to produce a car compared to Tesla's 10 hours. Then the rest of the auto industry still hasn't caught up to Tesla in that respect. And Tesla is moving to their third generation manufacturer, further improving the speed of manufacturing. Regarding this point, I believe the 2.5 hours does not include cell battery assembly. Tesla said Berlin would take 10 hours and would be their most advanced factory. This likely includes the battery. Volkswagen this said it takes them 30 hours for ID3, likely also including battery assembly. In as much as the current pace for Gigafactory Shanghai is already impressive, the facility is still being improved. It may already be Tesla's highest volume facility that's active today, but the electric vehicle maker is not known to stay still after hitting a milestone. As such, it would not be surprising if Gigafactory Shanghai's assembly speed still improves in the near future. So look for more reports from Torque News YouTube channel about this topic and subscribe to our channel. Now, previous reports have indicated that Tesla China would be unleashing the potential of Giga Shanghai the first quarter. As per an internal memo reportedly viewed by Reuters, Tesla China is reportedly looking to increase its output to nearly 20,000 vehicles per week for February and March. This strategy is expected to bring the facility to its output level in September, when it produced 82,088 Model 3 sedans and Model Y crossovers. Giga Shanghai is extremely efficient, so I'm so glad Tom Zhu, who did all of this with his team, will be in charge of the new Gigafactory in Mexico, as I reported, and he said that he wants to break Giga Shanghai's record at Giga Mexico. Now, as for about Tesla, there is a big recall going on in the automotive industry, which includes Tesla too. More than 1 million vehicles have been recalled by major car manufacturers in the latest batch of recalls posted by the U.S. National Highway Traffic Safety Administration. Car makers in this week's recall roundup include Ford, Tesla, Jeep, Dodge, and Toyota. So what happened? Ford recalls replacement airbags installed under previous recall. Airbag inflator replacements installed under a previous recall on older Ford pickup models are under recall because they may have been incorrectly installed, according to an NHTSA report. I will have the links of these, friends, in the description, so check the description as well. The airbag inflators may have been installed facing the wrong way, causing the airbags to potentially deploy improperly and increase the risk of injury during crash instead of saving you, according to report. The recall affects 98,550 Ford Ranger models, and those include 2004-2006 models. Tesla Model Y recalled over loose bolts. Tesla said 3,470 of its new model vehicles could have loose bolts in the second row seats, according to an NHTSA recall report. The report says the recall affects the second row seat back frame of Model Y vehicles, as the bolts securing the frames may not be securely tightened, which the NHTSA says could reduce the performance of the seatbelt system and increase the risk of injury during a crash. That those we recall includes 2022-2023 Model Y. As you can see, this is not over-the-air recall. This is a loose bolt. You have to take the car there to fix it. The company said it had not been aware of any injuries or that related to this recall. Owners are expected to be notified in the recall by mail beginning April 25. Why that late? I don't know. Tesla will offer to inspect that tighten the bolts for free. Of course, you gotta do it for free. Now, Dodge Durango, there is a spoiler recall. Dodge is recalling select Durango SUVs because the spoiler may detach, creating a hazard to other cars on the road, according to the NHTSA report. The spoilers on the recalled vehicles were installed over flush to the roof. This causes contact between the spoiler and the roof when opening the tailgate. Over time, the spoiler can wear and become partially detached from the vehicle, according to the report. A total of 139,019 Dodge Durangos are affected by recalls. Like I said, the recall vehicles are Dodge Durango from 2021 to 2023 models. Dodge said in the NHTSA report that it planned to begin notifying impacted owners on April 14 and offer a free inspection and spoiler replacement if necessary. According to the report, Dodge had been aware of reports of the spoilers become detached, but had not received reports of any collisions or accidents related to the issue. Nissan Rogue may shut off while driving. More than 700,000 Nissan Rogue SUVs are under recall because of a potential issue with the ignition key, according to an NHTSA recall report. Vehicles with jackknife-style keys can shut off while driving if the key collapses into the folded position, Nissan said, creating a crash hazard. Nissan said it has not been aware of any reports of injuries or crashes related to the issue. The recalled vehicles include 517,472 2014 and 2020 Nissan Rogue SUVs and 194,986 2017 to 2022 Rogue Sports SUVs. Lots of cars. Nissan said it will begin to notify owners of the recall on March 17, but it is still working on how to repair the issue. In the meantime, affected owners are advised not to attach any accessories to their key and only use it in the unfolded position until the remedy is available. When the manufacturer determines a repair, it will again notify owners by mail. Toyota Tundra LCD displays go blank. The LCD displays on 8,989 new Toyota Tundra trucks could fail to display key indicators like the speedometer and warning lights, increasing the risk of crash, an NHTSA recall report said. Toyota said it had received reports of the LCD displays going blank beginning in late October. A software issue was determined to be the cause. Recalled vehicles include new 2022 and 2023 Toyota Tundra, 2022 and 2023 Toyota Tundra Hybrid. All known owners of the subject vehicles will be notified to return their vehicles to a Toyota dealer, the recall report said. And also it said the dealers will update the software free of charge. Toyota said in the report it planned to notify owners between April 17 and April 23. Now back to our main news that I started reporting. What do you think about Tesla's improving production speed, friends? Tesla Giga Shanghai was recently featured, like I said, in an exclusive walkthrough from China's Xinhua news agency. I watched part of it. It's really interesting. I'm going to watch it. I will have the link in the description of this video. So over the course of the video, a number of key factors about massive electric vehicle factory were shared by with Xinhua. These included the facilities, Tesla Giga Shanghai's Tesla speed, which is quite remarkable. Also, Jeep is also included in the recall, but I don't want to make this video very long, but just, you know, comfortable for you guys. This is Armin Haryan. Give me thumbs up if you found this report useful and helpful. Let me know your thoughts about these recalls and why they're announcing these recalls that late. Why not earlier? Today's March, what, 5 or 6? Why announcing those recalls in April if you guys know that there is a danger, there is a hazard to bring them to the dealerships? And what do you think about Tesla's speed? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. God bless you, everyone. See you soon in our next report.